This video will cover the basic assembly of the Texas Instruments Robotic Systems Learning Kit, the TI-RSLK MAX. To learn more about this kit, visit ti.com/RSLK. Let's begin by identifying the components needed to assemble the robot. One Romy chassis base plate with the TI-RSLK chassis board already screwed on and the battery contacts installed. One right and one left bumper switch assembly, along with four nuts and 7/16-inch long screws. One 8-channel QTRX reflectance sensor array. One MSP432P401R launch pad board. Two Romy chassis motor clips. Two gear motors with encoders. Two Pololu wheels and tires. One Romy ball caster kit. One breadboard along with the standoffs, nuts, and screws. Before building, let's take a quick tour of the chassis board and take note of the primary elements. The male pin connectors for the TI launch pad are here. Battery input section with an on-off switch and latching button. TI 5-volt switching regulator, the TPS 568230. The TI 3.3-volt linear regulator, the TLV 1117LV. The TI op-amp, TLV 9004. TI motor drivers, DRV 8838, and the TI Hall effect sensors on the motors themselves, the DRV 5013. It's time to build your robot, so please gather the following. One Romy chassis base plate with the TI RSLK chassis board already screwed on and the battery contacts installed. One right and one left bumper switch assembly, along with four nuts and 7/16-inch long screws. One 8-channel QTRX reflectance sensor array, two Romy chassis motor clips, two gear motors with encoders, two Pololu wheels and tires, one Romy ball caster kit, and one breadboard along with the standoffs, nuts, and screws. Even though it's likely your chassis board and battery contacts are already installed on your Romy base plate, we'll still go over how to install these just in case you need to replace them at some point. Now let's flip the board over. Note the battery contacts on the underside of the board. These contacts need to pass through these openings on the Romy chassis. Place the chassis board in its approximate position on the chassis. Hold the board in place with one hand, compress the spring contacts, and gently maneuver them through the openings in the chassis. Next, secure the chassis board with hardware using these mounting holes. Place a nut in one of the recesses and then hold it in place with your finger. Insert a 3/16-inch long screw into the corresponding mounting holes in the board and tighten. Repeat for the other three mounting holes. Insert the battery contacts into these slots in the battery compartment. Next, install the bumper switches. Note the 1x4 header located on the underside of the chassis board here. Insert the pins on the bumper switch into this header, making sure that all four pins go in. Secure the bumper switch to the chassis using the included hardware in these two mounting holes. And repeat the whole process for the other bumper switch. The motor clips are identical, so either clip can install on either side of the base plate. Make sure you push the clip all the way into the base plate. You might hear a click before it's all the way in, but notice how the retention tab has not yet seated on top of the battery compartment. Keep pushing until the bottom of the clip is flush, here, and the retention tab has popped over the battery compartment like it has here. Repeat for the other clip. Like the motor clips, the motors are also identical and can be installed on either side of the chassis. Note the two TI Hall effect sensors on each of the motors, just behind the magnetic disc. These sensors create the encoder signals signifying the speed and direction of the motors. When installed correctly, the encoder pins from the motors should insert into these headers on the chassis board. It can be easy to put the motor in slightly crooked, so before pushing all the way down, make sure the retaining tabs on the outside of the clip are containing the motor. then push down on the motor, making sure the header on the encoder inserts into the header on the chassis board. Repeat this for the other motor. Now let's stretch the tires onto the wheels and install the wheels onto the motor shaft. Line up the D shape in the wheel hub with the D on the motor shaft. It will probably be difficult to press the wheel all the way down with your hand. So once it's on like this, put the chassis on its side and press the chassis down against the table to insert the wheel fully onto the motor shaft. Repeat this for the other wheel. Next, install the ball caster. The TI-RSLK comes with one ball caster that's intended for the rear of the robot. First, place the rollers into the cutouts for them, then place the plastic ball on top of the rollers. Push the ball caster retention clip over the ball and into the chassis so that the three legs snap into their respective holes. If you separately purchased a second ball caster for the front of your robot, go ahead and install that now. Next, install the 8-channel QTRX sensor array into the header pins near the battery compartment, being careful to line up the header so you aren't off by a pin. That covers the basic assembly of the TI-RSLK MAX, and you should now be ready to connect a TI launch pad to your robot. The TI-MSP432P401R launch pad is included in your kit and will have header pins installed here, 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 and here. The 5-volt shorting jumper should not be installed. If it is, you should remove it. Not doing so could break the chassis board. Connect the launch pad to the chassis board by lining up the pins on the sides of the launch pad with the corresponding pins on the chassis board. Then press on the sides of the launch pad, making sure the boards are pressed together evenly. Note that pushing too much on one side could cause the male header pins on the chassis board to get pushed or pulled out of alignment. Now your TI-RSLK MAX is assembled and ready to use. To learn more about this kit and what you can do with it, visit ti.com/RSLK. Thanks for watching.